where Seton Hall on a 9-0 run before a huge crowd, 8,318 on hand here today, the largest crowd since February 23, 2002 at the Rack, also against Seton Hall.
Yeah, and they've been into it. They really have. Rutgers is really making a game out of this. First half, had a chance to be down five. Ended up being a 10-point game at the half, but they fought back, starting with the defense.
Freeman working against Sonogo. Tough hook, and it goes in. Nice move by Deshaun Freeman to get clear of Sonogo and break the spell.
No, I like the iso, but I also like the patience of the rest of the team on the floor. Just stay out. Give your man space to work.
Powell, the lob to Sonogo. Trying to throw that back into Kale. A scramble. Delgado trying to finish the scramble on a rejection by Omoruyi. Sanders the little bobble. Here's Baker for three. And Omoruyi in there for the rebound. Good work by Omoruyi. Sanders in the corner to Mike Williams. That three won't go. Rebound tipped by Delgado into the hands of Sonogo.
Yeah, Omoruyi does a lot of good things for your team. It's great activity on the offensive and defensive end. I feel like Delgado's getting tired.
Looked like it there, didn't he? Sanders all the way to the rim, and nobody's stopping Corey Sanders, and Rutgers back within five. Powell. The bounce to Delgado. Working in the block against Omoruyi. Omoruyi the rebound.
He's just tired. He really is. He's tired. And that's to be expected. Rutgers has size. They've got good depth at the big position.
Nice hands by Miles Kale to intercept that bounce.
Just a lot of bodies wearing on. For Rutgers, you've got to take advantage of every opportunity you have, especially after a stop.
Freeman trying to get the crowd going here as Seton Hall sets up in the half court. Harrington. 8-foot floater. That's not going to go. Rebound underneath. A whistle and a foul. Omoruyi battling with Delgado down low. This will be a foul on Omoruyi and a timeout at the Rack. 3:52 remaining in the second half. Corey Sanders keeping the Scarlet Knights in it. Paul was the spark early in this one. Our State Farm assist of the game coming from Miles Powell.
I think Miles Powell just changes this team. I think he's the best player on this team. I really do. I think Miles Powell is the best player on this team because of what he can do, sharing the basketball, the way he understands the game, spaces out, comes hard off screens, and the way he shoots the ball from three.
Delgado, a turnover. Baker will push it up the floor. Bounce pass ahead. The finish by Omoruyi.
I thought for a moment about throwing that one down.
Oh, Steve Peichel getting the crowd into the game. There he is.
This is where you start to feel all your hard work come together. The execution's been there, defending very well. Of course you're going to want to get this crowd up into this game.
Carrington from the foul line. That won't go. Baker the rebound. Three-point game. 3:15 to go. Omoruyi to bounce down low to Freeman against Delgado. Delgado playing terrific defense, but a foul on the other side going against Desi Rodriguez, and Rodriguez with his fourth personal foul.
It's Omoruyi again. He's kind of got the body, and I want to be careful to say this. He's not there yet, but OG Anunoby, you know, you go back to OG Anunoby at Indiana, he's got the body, he's got that activity. He's just got to continue to improve upon his game. Every time you make a comparison, someone's like, no, he's not him. Like, no, he's not. Jeez, relax.
I'll delete my tweet. One more for Omoruyi. Coming up on BTN, our full slate of men's college basketball continues. Iowa, Ohio State, Illinois, all in action. Still to come right here on BTN, streaming live, BTN to go, and Fox Sports Go.
But with Omoruyi on the floor, you've got another big defender, a guy who can cover Angel Delgado, at least give him a shot. He's athletic. He's going to run the floor. He's going to put pressure in transition.
Omoruyi's got 8 points, 9 rebounds in this game. It's a two-point game as we come up on 3 minutes to go. Here's Carrington. Trying to turn the corner. Delgado, the bullet underneath the Sonogo. Rodriguez on the drive, and Rodriguez lost it.
really been the defense. I mean, their help side's in position. You got to be careful, though. If Izzy Rodriguez is able to gather himself, that's an easy dump down for a dunk. But it just seems like this Rutgers team is dialed in. They are dialed in. They are working hard on both ends of the floor. Been more patient.
Sanders from the foul line to tie it. Sanders coming up with a big bucket to close out the comeback.
I've been a little critical of Corey Sanders' defense, but he has gotten it going on the offensive end. I think that's what makes him so tough. He can beat you on the offensive end. And the big shot he just hit, contested jump shot coming off of a ball screen to tie things up. That's just what he can do. But if they can lock down here defensively, continue to frustrate Seton Hall, make them uncomfortable, got a chance to pull this thing away.
To your point about the defense, no points for Seton Hall in the last 3:35. They've missed their last five shots from the floor. And a 9-0 Rutgers run has tied this game up. Here's Carrington with a three. A little strong, rebound tipped by Freeman, and a foul.
I will say, 2 minutes and 23 seconds is a lot of time if you're going to rely on the emotions. So for Rutgers, it can't just be an emotional let's make this happen. It's got to be a go out and execute and get this win.
Sanders, one for one at the line. Two free throws, looking for Rutgers' first lead of the day. Down 10 at half. Down 13 midway through the first half. Now Rutgers up two. Harrington inside and a foul. Corey Sanders pleading his case that it wasn't a foul.
Oh, look, it was almost great defense. And it's more of just a misfortune foul than anything else.
Third foul, sixth team foul on the Scarlet Knights. Third on Geo Baker.
Just gets tripped up, but it's a foul. For them to get Desi Rodriguez in the game here with Mike Williams on him. It's an ISO down low.
Harrington will back it out. 2 minutes to play. Seven to shoot for Carrington. Wild shot. Freeman the board.
Oh, it's great defense. Corey Sanders locked in. Great contest. And then Freeman once again in position with a rebound.
Sanders calling for the freshman, Geo Baker. Wants it in his hands to run the offense. And now Sanders to work around the screen from Olorunyi. Defense again. Sanders the takeaway. And Rutgers starting to feel it right now.
I think Seton Hall's playing with a lot of confidence right now. And that's testament to what Rutgers has been able to do on the defensive end. I understand the concept of forcing the ball down low to Desi Rodriguez when you got Mike Williams on him in the paint. But when Seton Hall's at their best, it's when they're spacing, when they're moving the basketball, knocking down threes, letting Angel Delgado do work down low. But Rutgers has just taken everything away, and they've gotten this shot right here. A ball screen, side ball screen, two dribble pull-up jumper for Corey Sanders. He made one to tie it, and then that one to extend the lead.
It was 63-54. Rutgers in big trouble. And Seton Hall has not scored since. 6:06 remaining in the game when Seton Hall scored their last points. Rutgers, a 13-0 run down the stretch.
Well, there have been so many opportunities, but I think that when you have certain mismatches, you can't automatically go into it. And so go back to Desi Rodriguez, two plays in a row where the offense gets stagnant because you're trying to force the ball down low. I get the concept of it, but it takes you out of rhythm. It takes you away from doing what makes you best.
Drake and Iowa coming up after this one is over. Game two of our quadruple header on BTN, and what a start to the day on BTN. Good luck to the remaining three games to match this one.
Yeah, top this. I just hope, look, I hope that the Rutgers fan base sees what's brewing here in Piscataway. I hope you understand what's coming. Steve Peichel's done a fantastic job with this program, and when the environment is like this, this team's going to win a lot of games.
It's a hard place to play.
Yeah.
You can get this crowd consistently into it. 10 to shoot, 1 minute to go. Baker to work. Here's Williams for a three. Would have been maybe a dagger. Powell on the quick attack, and Powell is fouled.
No basket.
It's a good foul. Now Kevin Willard wants the intentional. I would argue that 50% of fouls are intentional. You know, if I get beat and I'm going to go up and try to
take
a shot, I intend to foul this guy. Now, I don't intend to hurt, but
what's the difference between intending to foul and intending to hurt four on Geo Baker?
That's what I'm saying. The intentional foul, you could probably call it 50% of the time.
Miles Powell at the line for the first time today. He's 15 for 18 on the year. One more to come for the sophomore from Trenton.
Rutgers, this is execution time. This is take your time. Trust what Geo Baker's been able to do, getting into the paint, making good decisions.
2-point game. 50.7 seconds to go. Sanders. Taking a little time here. 35 seconds to play.
Kind of a bit of a matchup zone here from Seton Hall.
10 to shoot. Sanders has got to go. 7 on the shot clock. Omoruyi. Omoruyi on the drive. The wraparound pass. Freeman is fouled with 1 to shoot.
I tell you, I've been so impressed with Omoruyi. Just look at the future of this program. The players that are being developed, they're becoming much better basketball players the more time they spend here. And the type of guys that Steve Peichel's going to get are guys that need to improve. I have a chip on their shoulder. Look at Geo Baker. I got something to prove. They've all contributed. These are big foul shots.
What's more impressive about what we've seen from Omoruyi today, this is a kid who didn't start playing basketball until the 10th grade. That is only young in his basketball career, but Omoruyi, 8 points, 9 rebounds, and a huge impact on this game as Seton Hall uses the timeout.
I mean, it's impressive when you think about where he's going to be after being developed, after getting more work, more time on the floor. I mean, I would say that a lot of the kids today are as good as they are because of the amount of time they play. We can criticize AAU, and yes, it is a mess, especially with young kids. The fact that young little 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10-year-olds are playing AAU basketball, it's crazy. But the specialization does bring out certain skills. So to see where a guy like Eugene Omoruyi is going to be in another year or two with some development, kind of picking up some more time on the floor, it'd be impressive.
We're talking with Steve Peichel earlier today, and he said, you know, this trophy is a great thing, and we want to bring this trophy back, but it doesn't really become a rivalry until we can beat each other in this rivalry. So they're 20.7 seconds away from this becoming a real rivalry again.
It's a really interesting thing for him to say. And that's just being realistic. That's also him being realistic with where his program's at. Say, look, we're close, but we're not going to really be a contender. It's also saying the same thing in the Big Ten. Really going to be a contender or even a competitor until we're able to win games. And I think that's where this team is. They're close, but until you're able to get over the hump and win some games, you're not yet going to be taking that seriously.
Don't forget Drake and Iowa coming up next. We'll get you there just as soon as this one is over. But this has been a day in town, man. I want it to end. One more for Freeman to try to make it a two-possession game. 3-point game, Seton Hall with the ball. Kadeem Carrington. The three for Powell. Halfway down, it won't go. Rebound by Williams and a foul.
Kevin, you talk about halfway down. That shot was all but in. And Mike Williams, how about the little guy on the floor? Just always seems to be. It was a great rebound, great guard rebounder. And that thing was all but in. 7.7 seconds. Big foul shots.
Still a one possession game. One more free throw. Williams saying, just calm down. Mike Williams, the senior, been on the losing end time and time again. His high school teammate, Kadeem Carrington, has had bragging rights. May not have them today. 7.7 seconds to go on a Rutgers timeout.
Some Rutgers student who actually threw a shirt on the floor. That's the last thing you need right now. I mean, when you got Corey Sanders going on there and saying, calm down, then you know
you've gone over the top.
You've been hyping him up the whole day. I mean, you can't say enough about the effort from this Rutgers team. And the effort is not just what you're seeing on the floor. And that's something of note. I mean, 0 field goals in the last 5:58. Clearly, that's how you know I'm reading something. I can't read. But the effort is what's going on behind the scenes in practice in terms of managing some of the personalities and this coaching staff. That's what brings itself to this environment.
Drake and Iowa coming up next. 7.7 seconds to go. Rodriguez and a timeout taken by Miles Kale. Advance it to half court. Quick timeout used. Their final timeout. Kevin Willard will draw something up.
You like the NBA rule there. Just call time. We got timeout. Just let them advance it.
You and I will disagree on that.
I like that idea. Well, because I'm so offensive.
I know, that's why.
Give these guys another chance to score. Kevin, I want to go back to it, man. Like, I've done some games here. You've done some games here. Where a few years back, it was sparse at best. There was no excitement. There was no passion in this program. And what you're seeing today is something that you can recruit to. You can certainly recruit to this. You've got new facilities coming. You've got a coach and a coaching staff who are investing in their team. And I hope this Rutgers fan base puts their investment in as well.
They added a couple tenths of a second onto the clock. 7.2 on the clock.
Now, what you don't want is a quick, easy one. You don't want to give a quick, easy one. Too quick, a lob to the rim. You got to pressure Corey Sanders on the ball.
Carrington inbounding. Carrington, the trigger intercepted. Omoruyi with the steal. And a foul. And that one is going to be a flagrant. Miles Powell called for the foul as Rutgers may be able to close out the biggest win in Steve Peichel's brief tenure as head coach. Miles Powell is
intense already. I mean, look, Omarui loses the ball a little bit, actually gave Miles Powell an opportunity, and that's just a little excessive. I would say a play on the ball is okay there. It's the arm coming down. It's the hard hammer.
Illegal non-excessive contact with an opponent above the shoulders.
Thank you, Webster.
It's the technical flagrant one.
Yes.
Verbiage.
And that was a pretty clear-cut flagrant one.
Don't look at it just to make sure there was nothing more there, but Corey Sanders and Mike Williams are starting to get this crowd rolling.
Understandably so. I mean, this is a team that we've said has been so close. They've been there. They've been there. They've been so close. And now they have an opportunity here. I mean, I would say 3.7 seconds left. They're going to close this thing out. These are the steps that you need to take as a program, too. I mean, statement games, top 25 games, and I have no idea what we're still talking about right now.
This one seemed pretty cut
and
dry.
Don't they know we've got Iowa and Drake coming on next? Jeez almighty.
Omarui going to the line. It's been a big concern, I know, of everyone in this building, that Drake Iowa's next on the team.
I don't think anyone knows. Not in this building.
And the possession for Rockford.
Two shots and the ball. And Omarui can really just close this thing out. Oh, he's been good today, John. 9 points, 9 rebounds, 20 minutes, no turnovers. He's had his hands on the ball.
Activity. He's around the ball. He's attacking the offensive glass. The tip jam was it. The tip jam was in. That got this crowd into it. A missed three. Mike Williams, a wide open three opportunity missed. Tip jam really got this crowd into it.
Seton Hall is going to close this game if they don't score without a bucket in 6 minutes and 5 seconds, and they're not going to score. And Rutgers pulls the giant upset at home.
And Deshaun Freeman just threw the ball up into the stands. Hopefully that fan gets to keep it, Kevin.
Seton Hall's 13-point lead gone. Rutgers wins it. Their first win against a ranked opponent since January of 2015 when they knocked off Wisconsin. Huge win for Steve Peichel and the Rutgers Scarlet Knights. Drake and Iowa coming up next. This has been an exclusive presentation of the Big Ten Network. For John Crispin, I'm Kevin Kugler saying so long.